Welcome back to the channel. I'm Hank Strange, and today we're talking about YouTube's new rules for live streaming when it comes to firearms. That means it's going to apply to guys like myself and you. Let's get into it right now. Okay, so full disclosure, a few weeks ago, YouTube actually reached out to me through email and they said, hey, there's something that we really want to talk to you about. But first, you have to sign and agree to all these NDAs. So after agreeing to several NDAs, I actually got on a call with YouTube, and it was pertaining to this stuff. On that call, I think it was about four or five people. At least three of them were lawyers, and they reminded me that I could not speak of this. So now, fast forward to today. These rules are public, so I am able to talk about it, and I'm posting it here on the YouTube/Hank Strange channel. Mostly, this is going to affect folks that go live, that live stream, like I do on Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded, which is the channel from which we broadcast our podcast Monday to Friday. If you want to check that out, it's the Who Moved My Freedom podcast, and it's on Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded. So if you search on YouTube, you'll find that. Now, the YouTube guys told me that they spoke to a few of the big dogs out there in the gun world. I don't really qualify for that. I think here on Hank Strange, we just crossed over 90,000 subscribers. But when it comes to going live, they said that they noticed that I actually went live a lot. Of course, that's what we do with the podcast. So that's, you know, that's kind of like some buildup for what's going on here. So today, another creator actually got in touch with me because he saw this blue banner. If you're a creator on YouTube, you see there's all these blue banners popping up there. I think there's going to be a few of those over the next couple of weeks. Usually at the end of the year, YouTube rolls out a bunch of new rules. So one of those popped up that was very interesting to him, and I'm going to read it to you guys. It says, we've updated YouTube community guidelines and won't allow live streams showing someone holding, handling, or transporting a firearm. And then there's a link that you can click on to show more. I'll try to roll that into, let's go to that link so I can give you guys the relevant information that comes up there before I talk about the conversation that I had with the YouTube guys. Okay, so that link is support.google.com/YouTube answers, and there's probably more stuff there, but I'll run that in for you all. Okay, so at the top of that, there is a video about policies on content featuring firearms, and then when you roll down, it talks about what this means for you. So there's already some rules that are in effect. I'm gonna go to the most immediate ones here that are relevant to what we're talking about. There's two of them that are relevant to live streams. Number one, live streams that feature someone holding or handling a firearm, regardless of whether or not they are firing it. Note, this does not include firearms in video games. And then the second one, live streams that feature someone transporting firearms from place to place, such as by carrying them or traveling with them by car, truck, or other vehicle. And then there's another note. Note, this does not include firearms in video games. So very clearly, firearms in video games are excluded from that. Okay, so that's what's in the information that's available out there. In our conversation, like I said to you guys, I was under NDA. Basically, what they told me is that they were talking to me because they realized that I go live very often for 2 hours. We usually do Monday to Friday for 2 hours, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. And we talk about a lot of things surrounding the lifestyles of firearms. We talk about politics, policies, new guns. We have companies come on. We talk about a lot of things. We just don't talk about guns, but I think we talk about the things that folks like ourselves are interested in, and you know, a lot of those are just things that human beings are interested in. But specifically, we spin around the lifestyles of folks that believe in the Second Amendment, like me and you. And what they were saying is that from once they announced this policy on my show, or anyone actually, anyone across the YouTube platform that goes live, okay? So not if you make a video, edit it, upload it, not that. That's not what they're talking about with this policy. But if you go live and you pick up a firearm and you're handling a firearm in that video, they will pull that video from being live. Now, they told me that in the beginning, they don't plan on giving strikes for that, but they will pull the video from going live. If you want to go back live, you'll have to restart everything. But it seems like in these policies, ultimately, they're going to be giving strikes to people if they handle firearms in a video when they're live. Now, my question to them is, why? Why this policy? And they told me that it was because they wanted to do something about some incidents that have happened where people have gone live and then committed some atrocities using firearms, and they want to prevent that from happening on their platform. Of course, I'm not happy about the fact that those things have happened in the past, but I'm very unhappy about the fact that folks like myself, that we are responsible firearms owners. You know, we practice safety. We, you know, in lots of cases, we have to, you know, we follow the law. We're protected by the Second Amendment. And there's lots of different hoops that we have to jump through in order to do what we're doing. Most of us are professionals. We're not the folks that they're talking about, yet, you know, we are going to be affected by this policy. They said that, you know, to them, that didn't really matter. This was an across-the-board policy that they were going to put into effect. So I asked them, how are you going to be able to tell that I'm picking up a firearm? And, you know, what if I'm picking up a toy? What if I'm showing a video? What if it's a picture in there or something like that? Now, they said to me, okay, if you're showing videos that are pre-recorded or pictures that were pre-recorded, pre-taken or whatever it is, you know, you're rolling in stuff from somewhere else, from YouTube or Instagram or something like that, as long as it's clear that that's what's happening, we're not going to pull the video based on that. But if you're handling a firearm, if you pick up a firearm and you're holding it in a live video, then we are going to do it. And so, you know, I wanted to know, how are they going to do that? Is it the algorithm? Is the algorithm somehow going to be programmed to be able to tell when I'm doing that? And their response to me was that they were going to actually have people watching our podcast when they go live. So that kind of threw me for a loop, right? Because, okay, we know they've got actual human beings out there. I don't know whether they're going to bring on new people to do this or how many people they have doing this. My understanding is lots of people are going live. But obviously, because I do guns, because I talk about guns and they know who I am, they're going to have people watching, people like me and like you, and like the other folks out there that talk about things related to firearms. That's really, really interesting to me. Maybe to them, they think it's a good thing. What I think of is, so now I have Big Brother, not just an algorithm, not just a computer somewhere. There's actually a Big Brother, a person watching me to see what I do. And I don't believe that they're going to be looking at me just solely to figure out what I'm doing, you know, whether or not I'm picking up this gun and holding it. I'm pretty sure they're going to be looking at lots of other things. And they could violate me for any other policies I don't know about, all kinds of things, right? As all of us that do YouTube, that are content creators, know about YouTube, they're very vague about their policies. Even just now, when I went into it, they're really very vague about that and other things, especially when you violate these policies and they pull your video, they delete the video, they give you a strike, they suspend you, or just kick you off the platform. They don't ever really say why, which makes it very difficult for you to fight back against that, to argue that, right? So to me, one, having this new policy is something that I am 100,000% against. And then to think that beyond that, there's actually going to be people watching folks like myself is very disturbing. You know, I have a feeling that the reason why they were talking to me and maybe some other people, I'll let those people speak for themselves. The ones that I spoke to weren't happy about it. So the reason why I think they were talking to us is because somehow they wanted us to convince you guys, or convince ourselves, or both, that this was okay, that this is an okay thing to do. To me, it's a very, very disturbing turn of events. Look, honestly, we know what's happening here. I've been saying this for a while on the podcast, you know, even here in videos. Whenever I speak to people, I've been telling them that there's stuff coming at us really, really fast. And since, you know, if you go back to 2013, when we got that first firearm again that came at us, folks like myself, I was just very new to YouTube at that time, in terms of this. And a lot of the guys who are out there that were already established, and then folks like myself coming online, we use the social media platforms to push back against what we saw as injustice, right? What we saw as a degrading of the Second Amendment that was going on. What things that we saw happening, we used that to push back. And I think they didn't really expect that, and it was very effective and maybe changed the course of events in lots of different ways. Now, since then, two things have happened. One, YouTube, all these other social media platforms, they're very wise to this, and they're creating policies to minimize and limit this, if not get rid of it altogether in the future. And two, I think a lot of folks out there now are asleep at the wheel when it comes to this. I think a lot of people aren't aware of what's going on, that we're facing other challenges. Maybe they feel like, oh, folks will be able to tell us about this and we'll know if something's happening. But people like myself, we've been trying to tell you guys that things are happening, but a lot of the policies that YouTube and other platforms have put into effect have served to minimize our presence, especially for people like me that are smaller. I think maybe the bigger guys have a better chance, you know, but they've already started minimizing us, and they're continuing to do that. So in my opinion, I can't say this is a first step, because it's definitely not a first step. There's other policies when you look at this. If you look at this here, before you go to those specific things, there's policies. You can't sell firearms or certain firearm accessories through direct sales, so you can't talk about that in your videos. You can't provide instructions on manufacturing firearms, ammunition, high capacity magazines, you know, homemade silencers, accessories. There's all these rules that they've already put in place that have made it very difficult for us to get our message out there. Lots of my videos have been removed from this channel, Hank Strange. Okay, I can't say that all of them have, but we are constantly removing videos. They're constantly reviewing videos, and even videos that at one point they said, oh, this is fine. Then they'll come back and say, oh, it's not. We argue it. Maybe we get it back. Then they come back again. Ultimately, they wind up saying, no, this, you know, we're going to demonetize this video, which suppresses the discovery of the video, which suppresses discovery of the channel and what we're saying. And so what we've been doing is removing those. Right? But when those also get removed, now they don't exist there, but they're creating policies that are retroactive. They're not saying going forward you can't do this. The videos that we've created in the past that are 100% legal for us to create, and topics that it's 100% legal for us to talk about and should fall under the First Amendment as well as the Second Amendment, you know, In lots of ways, they've been removing those channels or those videos, or limiting our ability to get those videos out to folks. It's really a tough situation. What can we do about it, right? First of all, YouTube, all these other social media entities are privately held companies. You know, they can do whatever they want to do. It's their sandbox, right? We're just playing in it. So we have to follow the rules that they create for us. And I just don't really think there's much else we can do about that. I know that I'm on other platforms, and I've been encouraging people to find me on other platforms, because I think in the next coming months, probably in, you know, before we have the next elections that are coming up, you're going to see a lot more people get deplatformed, pushed off the site, or just completely demonetized, and then your discovery, your knowledge of them even putting out videos being incredibly suppressed. So what can we do about that? This is YouTube's thing, and there's folks out there that say, oh, you know, you're going off to other places, but that, you know, you have to stay on YouTube. I agree with that. We have to stay on YouTube. We have to follow their rules. But at the same time, there's certain things that we cannot say or cannot do on YouTube. And, you know, even though there are other platforms that exist, which I'll talk about, which you can go to, it's very difficult to get everyone over there. It's going to take some kind of coordination with the content creators like myself, the folks out there in the industry, the people that run these platforms, and most importantly, you, the audience, to get out there and find those things and follow those things. Maybe we have to start putting our content up there uniquely. I'm speaking specifically about GunStreamer, which I'm on, lots of other folks are on. GunStreamer doesn't have a live ability, and they, I don't think, are going to have a live ability unless they get some serious support from the industry. And I don't know that we're going to see that anytime soon. So YouTube's still the only game, and these other major platforms like Facebook and Instagram are the only game. And I think that even though this is happening here with YouTube, you will see policies like this go over to those other platforms, at least for when it's live. But it's only the first step. It's not even the first step. This is probably not even the fifth or the tenth step. But it's a step, and it's not the last step. You guys will see more and more things happening here. When I was talking to them, I was very upset. I told them I didn't support it. I wasn't going to do anything in any way to support it. 100,000% I'm against this kind of stuff. I believe it's like a segregation of a section of our society. People like myself that believe in the Second Amendment, that believe in our right to be able to defend ourselves, we're being segregated and suppressed. This is what I believe about it. And it's very upsetting to me. It should be upsetting to you, but it's not. This is not the end. This is not the end. It's not the beginning. I think that we're going to see this escalate as things go forward here. So to not make this a massively long video here, what can we do? Okay, I'm going to try to stay on YouTube and as long as I can. This is why I have different channels. I have Hank Strange. I have Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded. I'm on other platforms like Facebook and Instagram and Twitter and all those things. I'm also on Minds. That's supposed to be more of an independent platform. If you guys are aware of it, you can find me on there. I'm not under Hank Strange because that was taken. I'm under The Real Hank Strange if you want to take the time to look that up. I think one of the important things that you can do is follow the people that, if they have a .com, like I have HankStrange.com, follow that. If they have email lists, get on their email list, you know. I have other ways that folks can get in touch with me. If you look at my social media, I'm often posting a phone number that I have that's attached to my phone that you could text me on. Even in certain cases, people call me up. We have to figure out how to stay in touch with each other. When my YouTube channel was deleted in the past, I had no ability to talk to those tens of thousands of people that were following me when they did that until I got the channel back. In the future, we probably are not going to get those things back. So we have to figure out how to stay in touch with each other. We also need to create our own ecosystem, even though I know in lots of ways that's a bad idea because we're pulling ourselves out of the bigger pool. Ultimately, what we're facing here with this kind of segregation, we need to create our own ecosystem, and it takes lots of people. Number one, it takes you guys participating in that. Go to the independent things out there that are pro First and Second Amendment. Go to those platforms, follow your favorite content creators on there, figure out how to keep in touch with them, figure out how to support them in whatever ways you can, right? I know not everyone could do the same thing. We're on Patreon, and we do what we can to keep this whole thing going. It, you know, in a lot of ways, it costs money to do this, and it takes an incredible amount of time. But the audience is the most important thing. I think after that comes the content creators, right? We create the content for you guys. We give you this information, we entertain you, we warn you of things that are gonna happen. So it's important for us to diversify what we're doing and not solely be on these platforms. I think it's incredibly important for the industry to get behind this. In lots of ways, the industry is way, way, way behind on this. I talked to lots of people, including some that have, I think, really the resources to help to do something about this, and they're way behind. They're all sitting on the fence. They're not doing anything. They're all waiting for the apocalypse to hit, and I think that that's not a good idea. And then we do need more people who can create these platforms to do it. I know not everyone's going to survive. I know it's incredibly expensive, but I think if we get like all the right ingredients going here, we can create our own ecosystem. And when this happens to us, we can at least go over there until we're able to do something, or you know, I don't know if we'll ever be able to come back to places like YouTube. I don't know if that's ever going to happen. And it sucks, it's horrible, but ultimately this is the way everything's going in the world. And we just have to deal with it. That's what I believe in, right? That's what you probably believe in. So, you know, like I said, I don't want to make this incredibly long. I know that this news, Sound of Freedom right there. I love it when I hear gunshots in the neighborhood that just aren't for me. You know, I live out in the country. Lots of people are out here enjoying freedom. So that's awesome. You know, the thing is that there's going to be more of this, I think, coming in the future. So we just need to be prepared for that. When it comes to this policy, I know it's just coming out, and there's going to be content creators that are really worried about this. And I have to tell you, I'm incredibly worried, because I don't know how they're really going to enforce these policies. Who's going to be doing it? Who knows who's going to be sitting there looking at this, or the combination of a person and the algorithm, how those things are going to think about things, how quickly people are going to get hit. And definitely it's not the last policy that's going to be coming at us. So be prepared for it. I just think things are going to really go downhill from here and get worse for those of us that are patriots and believe in the Constitution, and especially and specifically the Second Amendment. Why? Because, you know, you don't have anything you can't defend. This is what I always tell people. And if you can't defend your freedoms, you don't have them. So get ready for it. If you have questions, please put them in here. This is going to carry on for some time. I'm not doing a podcast tonight. I'm going to try to throw this up as quickly as I can. I'm not doing a podcast. I'm going on a date with Lola. You know, if you're married, your wife makes a date with you, you can't mess with that. So I'm going to do that tomorrow. I will be on Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded doing the Who Moved My Freedom podcast on that channel. So go over there, subscribe to that channel as well. Who knows how this is going to go, guys. I'm just as worried about it as a lot of folks out there. And all I can do is say, be prepared. They're going to keep coming at us. I'm going to end it there. I want to please invite everyone to thumbs up this video, comment, definitely ring the bell so that you can be notified when we go live. Share the video, ask questions. I'll get to them as soon as I can. And if you want to see a longer conversation about this, check out the podcast. I'll try to put a link or something in there. We won't be able to do this anymore when we go live on YouTube. Sad day. There's more coming. I'm Hank Strange. Peace out.